Welcome to the next episode of Pop-Up Tech Talks. I'm here in Barcelona at VMworld, and I have the pleasure of having Rebecca with me. So Rebecca, would you mind introducing yourself shortly?
My name is Rebecca Fitzhugh, and you can find me on Twitter at Rebecca Fitzhugh.
Short and sweet, as I like it. Rebecca, would you mind tell me what do you think about today's keynote? What did you find most exciting and interesting about it?
So I think for me, kind of combining yesterday and today's keynote into kind of one conversation, is that I think it's becoming increasingly apparent and important that we need to be looking at further up the stack. The infrastructure is still important, but it's becoming more of a consumable endpoint, and we need to be looking more at an application layer, especially as we move into the cloud. So the idea of lift and shift works for some use cases, but others we really need to be looking at re-architecting applications.
I don't know what to say about this because I'm not a technical person, but I think data is the lifeblood of any business, really. So we at NetApp believe that data should be easy to move everywhere, whether it's a public or a private cloud, whether it's on-premise. So what do you think about the mobility of data?
Yeah, I think that's absolutely a very important thing, because at the end of the day, again, kind of like the infrastructure matters, but it doesn't matter to the end user, right? What matters to the end user is having your data available always. And so I think cross-cloud migrations are going to become more and more important, because you're going to have some applications and some use cases that are better for one public cloud provider than another, so you're going to start leveraging more. So being able to move your data anywhere is very important, so you're going to see more of that coming out. And so NetApp is a great example of the data focus, and there's other vendors that are doing that as well, and you're going to see more of that, because the data and ability to move from on-premises to cloud and between clouds is going to be very, very important in the next few years.
Yeah, I can't wait for that time. I think at some point people wouldn't even know what kind of infrastructure they have in-house. All they would care is, where's my data and how can I access it right now, whether it's on my phone, whether it's like any device. Nobody would really care about those things, don't you think?
I agree completely. Like when I, for example, order an Uber, I don't care about the underlying infrastructure, right? I don't care if those applications are being hosted on premises or in the cloud. I don't care what public cloud provider. What I care about is that the application works and I'm able to have a car show up and take me to the airport, right? So we're going to see more of it. It doesn't matter where the data is, as long as the data is there and it's protected.
Yeah, absolutely. I think everyone should embrace the data. At the end of the day, it's what powers, it's like knowledge is power. I think nowadays data is power. Like having data is an invaluable resource that it's unique to every company, and they should do their best to preserve it, to save it, obviously from ransomware attack whatsoever, but also use it for many purposes and for innovation.
Absolutely, move it too, right? So if you need to go from one place to another, you want to be able to do that quickly without a lot of legwork.
Yes, guys. If you don't know what she's talking about, just Google Data Fabric NetApp. I'm not trying to promote ourselves, but that's what we do, because we're trying to embrace that vision that everyone in the industry should be data visionary.
I agree.
Thank you so much for your insights. And one last question. So, because we're girls here, so who's your favorite female superhero?
Beyoncé.
Wow, I didn't expect that. Go big girl. Thank you for being with us at Pop-Up Tech Talk. We're looking forward to seeing you next time.